Hi, this is Alicia Katz-Pollock from learn.royalwise.com, and welcome to our latest installment of Look What I Found, where I take a look at new features in QuickBooks Online so that you know all your options so that you can make the best decisions for yourself and for your business. Today, I want to talk about a new feature that a lot of people have been asking for a really long time, the ability to use your own Gmail address so that when you send invoices to your customers through email, it comes from you and not from a generic email address at notifications@intuit.com. So this way, every email comes from your Gmail. So let's take a look at how to set it up and how it impacts your workflow. So here I am in my company file, and let's go take a look at one of my invoices. So I'll head over to invoices and let's find one to use as an example, like this one here. So here we have an invoice for one of our clients. It's going to get emailed to them at this email address. And I'll go down to the bottom right-hand corner and click on Save and Send. When it's in the Send window, I can see here the generic email address that it usually comes from. And that one can't be replied to either, or they get an error message. But if I drop that down, here's what's new. See how it says, from, new, hey, look at me. Anytime you see the pink circle, definitely check it out. Here it says add Gmail address. So I'll go ahead and click on it. Now it says send invoices from your Gmail address, and I'll click connect Google account. It's going to bring up any Gmail addresses I already have. If you see the one that you need, you can just click on it. If you don't, you can use another account and then go ahead and log in. But I'll choose my royalwisesolutions@gmail.com. And now it wants to verify Intuit. QuickBooks wants to access your Google account. This will allow Intuit QuickBooks to send an email on your behalf, which is exactly what we're after. It does say, make sure you trust Intuit QuickBooks. I trust Intuit QuickBooks. So I will go ahead and click OK or allow. And now it makes the connection. And now I can see my email address as the from in the email. Now, note that it's not really coming from your Gmail address. It really is still coming from Intuit's server, but the reply to and what your clients are going to see is the Gmail address. So let's go ahead and send that and see how it plays out. Now that I have sent the email, let's go take a look at our email. One thing that I see here, so now I'm looking in the Royalwise Solutions Gmail account, and here's an email saying from Google saying that Intuit QuickBooks was granted access, and so that way I have a confirmation. And if you ever got that message and you didn't initiate it, you would know that maybe somebody was trying to hack you. But this is good. This is exactly what we want to see. Now let's see how it plays out. Our client email address is right here, and here's the email from the client. So I'll go ahead and click on it. And we can see that if you click on the email address, you can see that it came from Gmail, not from Intuit. We see the whole invoice, we see the review and pay button. So if you are using QuickBooks payments, they can pay right from here. And if I scroll down, I have my settings on so that it attaches the email as a PDF. I can see this immediate invoice right here. And just so you see the workflow, if I was the client and I clicked review and pay, it would then take me into a payment portal where I can go ahead and pay the invoice right then and there. But let's head back to the email addresses. Now, one thing that I want to point out here is that if I go and look in the sent items for that email address, I don't see a sent message here. It's only using it as a reply to. But here's what it will do for you. If I, let's say I was the customer and I owe $76,000 and I want to know, do I have to pay all of this at once? So I'm going to click on reply and ask if I can make multiple payments. And then they'll send that email, and then you as the bookkeeper will find it in your Royalwise Solutions email. Let's go ahead and check our mail. And there it is. So now you can have conversations with your clients in your email. The next place that we want to see the end results is if we open up the email itself, or rather, I should say, open up the invoice itself. And this is the same invoice that we just sent. And if we scroll down, you can see the activities here. You can see when an invoice was emailed, and you can see every time that they responded to it or viewed it. And this is one of the reasons why it's not really being sent from your Gmail. It's still being sent from Intuit server, because that's how it knows what's actually happening with the activity on the invoice. And so it's nice that you can always see that at a glance. In addition, if I look at that same invoice and I click on the orange status over here, I can see that it was sent and when it was viewed. So essentially, you're getting the best of both worlds. You're still getting all the benefits of the email being sent out through Intuit server with all of its tracking, but you can, the customer's experience is that they're getting the email from you, and if they respond, it's you on the other side. So I think this is a great enhancement to QuickBooks Online. I'm really excited about it, and definitely check it out in your own program. This is Alicia Katz-Pollock at royalwise.com, and let me know what you think of this feature in the comments. I'll see you in the next class.